Hello guys, and welcome back to another episode of FTB Infinity. And it's episode number 11. Last episode we actually built the huge storage core or energy core down there. And we got the super builder's wand. So we can take a look at our core actually. So let's take a look at it. It's been running for quite long, and actually from the core I'm powering the quarry that's running. So we take a look, it's got 158 billions of RF. So yeah, it's pretty much more than we ever used, and as you can see it's slowly gaining the power. So our solar power is actually enough to provide energy for this core and even power the quarry. So you can see it's quarrying right now, it's going on full speed. And what we are going to do in today's episode, well, the episode before, we've built this room with a lot of crafting CPUs, and in between episodes I actually wired it up and I somehow built this. I actually love those smoky quartz blocks, they are kind of awesome. And yes, so we've got this. So what we are missing is actually some crafting assemblers or atomic assemblers where we can actually craft our items. So I've prepared this room, it's nothing fancy, just to, you know, put those assemblers in actually, because yeah, most of the time we won't ever be in this room, so it's just a flat box. Yeah, and we need to put those assemblers in. And as we tested the assembler, if we put it interface, well, actually I can actually grab a whole stack and assembler, molecular assembler. So if we put the assembler like this, it's only taking one channel. So those assemblers do not count as channels because we've got this interface. And the way I want to have this is to have like pillars of 8 coming up to this quantum link chamber. And oh, why we are not having a power? This is not good. We are not gaining a power into our system. Energy cell. I don't know why we are not gaining power. Well, actually, I've got this guy right here, and this guy should be able to actually take care of this. Yeah, now we are having power, 9 channels through 18. Yes, I don't know what's happening sometime here. Maybe after the server restart, this actually, I don't know. I will let this energy cell here just in case. So the way we want to have this is like have pillars of 8, those interfaces on those 4 spots. So if you count with me, it's 4 times 8, so it's 32 channels. So we will actually take this yellow wire, cable, this yellow cable, and we are going to run this cable like this. And from this yellow cable, we are going to put some P2P tunnels, and actually one more, I guess. Two more, yes. So we are going to take a P2P tunnels, and from those P2P tunnels, of course, we will wire the dense cables. And yeah, because there are four of them, and so it's 8 by 4, so it means 32 channels. So for one group of four, we'll take one P2P channel to kind of make up for this, because right here, when our storage is, we are using only like one dense cable with 4 and with 8 channels. So yeah, actually we are using 7. So with 11 channels, I guess. So we want to make up for this. And actually, we are going to build something right above it. Like maybe some processing stuff or something like that. So yeah, I will eventually take channels or take dense cables from this quantum ring, and I will wire it up. So don't worry, I will make use of this quantum ring more efficiently. So yes, so let's just wire this thing in. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and the last one is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So now we can take our molecular assemblers and we can put them all the way on this. So like that, like so. And when with this setup, what this can actually do is that the one interface with some patterns in it can use all those four molecular assemblers. So it can actually speed up the process of crafting a little bit, just a little bit. So like that. And I will eventually end up taking some from our base. Like, we don't need, for example, the redstone block. We don't need the crafting table, and we need planks for the crafting table. Okay, so yeah, I have the ender and this. So we will take those. And let's go back to our new base and let's take them and stick them. I will just pop this guy off for a moment. So let's stick those in like so. Okay, so we've got those in. So we can now take this molecular assemblers. So we now need to take a look on what cables we want to use. So we are not using the blue one, okay? So the purple one, the brown one, and the green one. So let's take blue one, purple one, brown one, and green one. And do we have smart cables? Light blue, okay. So we need smart cables. 1, 2, 3, 4. And we want a purple, okay. We want a green one, we want a blue one, and we want a brown one. So let's quickly craft those up. So the purple, the green one, blue, and the last one is... purple, blue, green, brown. Yes, I do not have brown one. So we'll take those cables. I can put this back in. And we need a P2P tunnels. We just need one. Just for now. And we want a memory card, so let's take that. And we want to take, for example, the purple one. So we've got our memory card, and now what we can do, okay, here's the middle, like so. So we can now load the settings into this and take a... we took the purple, right? I can't remember. Let's just take a look for... yeah, the purple one. So we took the purple one. So we want to take this cable and run it like so. And we want to take the smart cable and run it like that. Like that. Okay, so it's 8 channels here. 8 channels here. And it should be 16 channels right here. So if we wire this right here and this right here, so it should say 32 channels, right? Yes, 32 channels. And here at our controller, this should say 32 channels. Yes, that's right. So right now, if we were about to order maybe some crafting tables, and we want, I don't know, 5,000 of them. So let's start that, and you can see it's processing all of those crafting tables. And we actually want to speed it up. So, no, I didn't mean to do that. So we want to actually put acceleration cards like that into, great, like so, and we run out of acceleration cards. It doesn't matter. So as you can see, crafting tables. It's going pretty fast because we've got like 4 of those Domic assemblers in one interface. So this is going pretty fast. So acceleration card, can I craft like 1,000 of those? Yes, I can. So I will start this. So we will need a lot of actual acceleration cards, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 for atomic assemblers. There's 32 of atomic assemblers, and I've got some lags actually right now. So yeah, I've got a 32 atomic assemblers, and I've got 4 on each side, and I've got 4 in total, and I've got 5 in. Oh my, no, I got it that wrong. So it's 8 per 1, or 32 per 1, by 4, it's 128 in 1, and we need to take this number and by 4, so it's 512 in total right here, and we need to take this number and by 5, it's 2,560. Oh my god, it's a lot. So I will actually complete those atomic assemblers and I will be right back. Alright guys, so as you can see, there are no molecular assemblers right here. So it means I actually take all those patterns and I actually put them in here. So yeah, now we can take a look in our new base. So if we go this way, we've got everything right here. And as you can see, there are a whole bunch of molecular assemblers. They are all wired in. And in fact, in every molecular assembler, there's acceleration card. So yeah, it was quite tedious job actually. And I don't know why, but my FPS are dropping here. So actually in every assembler is acceleration card, and it was kind of tedious job, and thank god you can actually shift click them in. So yes, we finished this. So what considering AE, we need to do just a few more stuff, put those, put all the this crafting things in our new base, like those three, those chargers, those inscribers, and this pool, the super pool. So yeah, that's something that we need to do to actually complete everything from the AE. And we are kind of set up pretty good. And yes, my FPS are dropping low again. I don't know what's causing it. So yes, I still need to create again this room. I need to make it smaller. So as you can see, I've been crafting a whole bunch of those 64 key storage cells, so we are actually doing a pretty good job on the storage. And one last thing that I would like to do is actually take a smart cable, and I guess we can take like the cyan one. Smart cable, cyan, and still we need to hook those terminals in our base. And the way I want to do it is put them like that and go all the way up like so. Actually, I guess one more, and then I'm going to go like this, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we want to take a crafting terminal, and I do not have a pattern for it. Actually, terminal. Yeah, I've got one ME terminal right here. So we can put this in. And we will need more. So let's go to our base. And we need terminal. So we need a crafting terminal. Okay, we do not have the calculation processor. Calculation. Let's make, I guess, 10. So, terminal. So, we need the crafting terminal. And do I have. Not yet. Okay. So, we need interface terminal. And we. Oh, yes. We've got the interface terminal. And I actually have the pattern for illuminated panel, right? Illuminated panel, yes. So you want to put this in interface terminal. Then we want the pattern terminal. And for the pattern terminal. Oh, we need the crafting terminal. ME terminal we have, interface. So we need the crafting terminal. I want the. Okay, I can't spell it right. Is it like. Okay, so we've got illuminated. Why we do not have terminal? This requires crafting terminal, ME terminal. Do you have a pattern for it? I can't remember. ME interface terminal. So ME interface terminal, ME terminal. So terminal like so, and we do not have the annihilation core. So to craft one of those, great. Okay. Oh, annihilation core. So we've got this and terminal. So the crafting terminal should be available right now. Oh, the ME terminal. Okay. So like this, and we need one crafting terminal for the pattern terminal. Yes, so we should in theory have all those terminals, so we can put them in like so, and now we can go back to our base room, go up here. So we've got the ME terminal, so let's grab just few more, like 3 more. For this we want 4 more. For this we want 4, and for this we want 4. So I will actually wait for those to be crafted and I will be right back. Alright guys, so I've got all those terminals that we are going to need. And we've got the ME terminal, so now we want the interface terminal to be right here. We want the ME terminal to be right here and the pattern. Oh, ME terminal interface. Wait. There's something wrong. Crafting terminal, like so. And we want this. So you've got the interface terminal, crafting terminal, and the pattern terminal. Yes, so now we want to go the same on this side. It's actually too much. So. Okay. So we want to have the crafting terminal on the top, and then it's ME terminal interface pattern. So the ME terminal interface and pattern. Oh, and we are running low on. Okay, so we want actually cable, and we want to take a dense cable for this because we run out of the channels. So we want to actually take this off and put the dense cable like that. And we want to take you off and bam, bam, and actually one more. Bam. So from here, we want to go again like this. Okay, it's too much, too much. And we want to have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And we want to have the crafting terminal, the ME terminal, the pattern terminal, and the interface terminal. And one more, like so. One. Okay, not like that. Boom. Like so. Okay, so the ME terminal, the pattern terminal, and the interface terminal, and we want terminal, and we want the crafting one more. Okay, come on. Okay, we want one more crafting terminal. So in theory, we should be able to access all those terminals. So yes, that's right. So we've got 16 more channels on this. And yeah, I actually want to have this wire to go up. Because I like the way it looks. And one thing why I left those two terminals, because there are two more, the Arcane Crafting Terminal and the Essentia Terminal. And because we want to kind of get our ways someday in a Thaumcraft, I actually leave those two spaces for those terminals, so we can then have them with all the others. So yeah, I guess that will be it for today's episode, guys. We actually done quite a lot of work today, so we've got pretty much everything that we need for the AE. Pretty much everything, except those three machines that we still need to do. So yeah, we'll work on that the next episode. Maybe not. Maybe we want to take a look at something else because we've been doing this all the time. So maybe we'll take a look on Botania or something like that, because I really want to get into Botania and Tomcraft. So yes, maybe we'll do this instead of doing like tech again. So yeah, thanks for watching, guys. If you like this video, please leave a like, it's appreciated, and consider subscribing. It always making my day when I see someone new subscribe to me. So thanks for watching, guys, and see you next time.